Hello, my name is Michalis Papadimitriou and I'm a PhD candidate at the University of Manchester. Today I'm going to present you the work Transparent Compiler and Runtime Specializations for Accelerating Managed Languages on FPGAs. Today's agenda is the following. First, I'm going to give you a short introduction to the main motivation and background of this work. Then, I'm going to present you the main contribution, which is a set of extensions for the TornadoVM framework that allow the FPGA execution for Java programs. Moreover, part of this presentation is an experimental evaluation against several benchmarks. Finally, I'm going to outline some concluding remarks and some future research directions to this work. Now, let's start with the motivation and background. Many of you may be already familiar with FPGAs. FPGAs are semiconductor devices that are based around a matrix of configurable logic blocks, CLBs, connected by programmable interconnects. These devices have the unique characteristic to be able to reprogram after manufacturing. Therefore, hardware can provide the exact needs of a specific algorithm and therefore to reach up to tens of teraflops performance. Due to this aspect, many of cloud providers like AWS and Azure made them widely accessible. However, a key bottleneck of the accessibility of FPGAs is their programming aspect. Programming FPGAs need to have deep understanding of the underlying hardware. Let's talk a bit about the programming aspect of FPGAs. Until just a decade ago, programming an FPGA was highly aligned with the synthesis software. Synthesis can take as an input a description of the required design written in a hardware description language like VHDL or Verilog, and generate an executable that contains the design, the so-called bit tree. However, FPGA vendors, to make them more accessible, they provide an alternative to this process, the high-level synthesis. Now, high-level synthesis can take a traditional algorithmic description written in C and provide the means for a high level of abstraction. Also, lately, HLS vendors, they allow parallel programming constructs like OpenCL as an input for the HLS software. However, the vast majority of programmers tends to use even higher programming abstractions like managed languages Java, Python, Ruby, and R that are running on top of the JVM. So a main question emerges: how can we make a managed language like a Java to make from the FPGA performance? To answer this question, we review the state-of-the-art frameworks that allow programs written in Java-based constructs. Each framework provides a different set of features. In this work, we provide to use the TornadoVM framework along a set of extensions to allow dynamic code generation, runtime optimizations, and seamless compatibility with the HLS software stack. To motivate our proposal, we reproduce the experiments from a paper, Dynamic Hardware Configuration. As you can see on the left-hand side of the graph, the original TornadoVM code that targets CPUs and GPUs performs rather poorly on an FPGA. However, by exploiting the optimization space, we managed to obtain up to 218x speedups compared to the Java hotspot when manually tuning the generated code. So, a main question emerges: how can we enable the execution of a Java-based program onto FPGA transparently? In the following slides, I'm going to present you the key contribution of this work. What we propose in this work are two distinct contributions. Firstly, we propose a set of runtime extensions to enable the functional integration of TornadoVM software stack with the high-level synthesis software stack. This is achieved by adding different execution modes to fulfill different needs and promote reusability. Then we propose a set of compiler optimization to enable high performance for the generated code while targeting FPGAs. Here is an overview of the TornadoVM system. With blue, we annotated pre-existing components, and with light red, components that we introduced or modified during this work. We modified the runtime by enabling three different modes: the ahead-of-time mode, that allows the plug-in of a pre-compiled bitstream to the TornadoVM during runtime; the full JIT mode, that enables the end-to-end JIT compilation and execution of a Java code onto FPGA by creating a separate Java thread that makes a direct call to the vendor's HLS compiler for OpenCL; Finally, we introduce an emulation mode that aims for fast prototyping and initial debugging, and also for functional validation of the generated FPGA kernels. This video provides insight of how the FPGA emulation mode can be used through a Java IDE like the Intel IJ in a few easy steps. One can prototype quickly an input Java application and see estimates on hardware utilization before going to the full JIT mode. This video and the open source repo provide detailed instructions on how to reproduce it. What we discussed so far ensures functional integration, however, does not guarantee performance. Another crucial aspect of this work are the modifications made in the compiler level to ensure that the generated code can target FPGAs. As the FPGA execution depends on a vendor-specific bitstream, the compilation process is split into two stages. We modify the Tornado JIT compiler by adding custom nodes and optimization phases to guide the code generation for compatibility with the high-level software. Let's see now the optimization process. Here is a private method that captures the computation of a discrete Fourier transform while using the Tornado VM API. Here we see a simplified version of the compiler graph for this method. Red arrows denote control flow, while dotted lines denote data flow. The first optimization is to add scheduling nodes. This allows the generated code to contain the exact configuration of threads to be deployed, and this influences the layout of the final design in the FPGA. Then we identified that Pragma unrolls performs better than unrolling loops before the HLS compilation. Thus, we identify non-parallel counting loops, and instead of the unroll them, we attach custom unroll nodes on the loop bedding. Finally, we identified that the parallel loops do not require to keep their structure on its generated code, as the reduction variable relies on the thread IDs. Therefore, keeping the structure prevents the HLS software to exploit pipelining between threads. Thus, we introduced a new optimization phase for parallel loops to be flattened, while keeping the thread ID for indexing. Now let's talk about the experimental evaluation of our toolchain. To evaluate our complete system, we used an experimental setup that consists of three hardware devices, an Intel multi-core CPU, an Intel Aria 10 FPGA with 8 GB of RAM, and an Intel integrated GPU. We also used a regular Linux-based setup with the Tornado VMZ version of 0.7. Finally, we had a selection of 6 different benchmarks with different compute characteristics. We evaluated raw performance benefits against 3 different baselines. First, against JIT compiled Java code. Initial results showed that for medium and large sizes, we achieved speedups for most of the benchmarks. DFT was the most high-performance benchmark that achieved 224x speedups compared to Java Hotspot. Another comparison is against multi-threaded Java implementations that they were running on 8 threads. These results showcase similar trends, and again the DFT was the most high-performance benchmark with a speedup of 19.8x. Finally, we compared our toolchain against parallel code running on the integrated GPU through the Tornado VM framework. This time, the maximum performance that we reached was 13.8x speedup. As we mentioned in the very beginning, FPGAs are about customization, thus being able to assess the resource utilization is a key performance metric for the efficiency of our generated code. This table illustrates the total number of LUTs, flip-flops, DSPs, and BRAMs per design for each individual benchmark. On this selection of benchmarks, we need to note the given performance for two of the benchmarks. Black Scholes and Embody denote a very high number on BRAM utilization. This means that the unroll optimization that we perform increases the number of total registers per design. Some other important observations emerge from this result is that we managed to utilize just 25% of the given area of the FPGA. Also, each bitstream had the size of 172 megabytes, and it took about 62 minutes to generate the bitstream through the HLS software. So there is still space for improvement. Now I'm going to sum up this presentation. We proposed an open source software solution. Detailed instructions are available on the public repo of the Tornado VM. The complete toolchain can outperform serial multi-threaded Java solutions. Also, it allows quick prototyping for inexperienced users through the Java ecosystem. Finally, it provides a set of optimizations integrated with the Graal AI. For the future work, we aim to improve the quality of the generated code by using vendor-specific features such as channels and pipes from Intel to increase resource utilization. In addition, we plan to investigate the co-execution of multiple kernels. Thank you for your attention and feel free to contact me through my email for any further questions.